Hey nerds, welcome back to Nerd News. I'm your host, Dan and Neil. And today, I asked the question, was it good that Snoke died in The Last Jedi? This is just a random video idea that I had, and I thought it might be a discussion topic for the channel, and I thought it would be a good discussion topic. Whether or not you like or hate The Last Jedi, it's still a movie, and if you disagree with my opinions in this video, please save them to the end. I really want you guys to watch it and hear out my opinions, and I'll listen to your opinions in the comments section down below. Well, my first point on this would be that now since Snoke died, by the hands of Kylo Ren, no less, Kylo has more time to shine and sets him up for an interesting character arc that we have never seen in a Star Wars movie. At the end of the movie, we leave Kylo not good or evil, but in limbo. He is stuck in this place where his destiny in the Star Wars universe is undecided, and we don't know where it's going, and he doesn't either. You might say this is exactly what happened to Vader, but this is similar to what happened to Vader, not exactly. Vader killed his master to save his son and choose the light side in the end, and 5 minutes later he dies. That's it. He's good at the end. Kylo kills his master in the second episode of this trilogy to prove that he is not a pushover and that he doesn't need Snoke. This story arc that is leading into episode 9 wouldn't have happened if Snoke did not die. Kylo did not do it to save Rey. Well, he kind of did do it to save Rey, but to get her on his side of basically, let's rule the galaxy together. He doesn't like the dark or the light. He just wants to be him. You could also make the argument that we didn't learn enough about Snoke before he died, which I do agree with. It sucks that now since the character is dead so early that we just met him, he almost has nothing to add to the Star Wars universe. See how I said almost? If you die in the Star Wars universe, that's not the end of your story. That's just the beginning, basically. Almost every Star Wars character has gotten a solo comic series, a book, everything. Probably a TV show episode and then Clone Wars. Everything. Snoke has been confirmed for a one-shot comic series coming in December 2019, right around episode 9. So I bet there are going to be some important details in that, and we learn in episode 9, and they're going to be connected in some way. That's my theory about that. It may also be better that we are told about his origins in the comics. In comics, fans are a little more accepting of crazy things happening, and that's just a fact, than they are in casual movies. There almost is no budget in a comic series. You can do series. There's no series bounds to the story anymore if it was told on TV. And also, if you do remember, in the first trilogy, we didn't know about Vader. I mean, we knew Vader was his father, but we didn't know about that other creepy guy that was ruling Vader. Yeah, we didn't know about him until he died. We didn't even know about him until after he died, until the prequels. Am I saying we should get a whole prequel series on Snoke? No, but a good comic series would suffice. So, was it good that Snoke died? Well, in my opinion, yes. This allows new stories to be told for new characters like Kylo Ren and Rey. Also, it's not like Snoke's gone. Like I said before, his story just started. But I did say this is my opinion, so I understand that yours might be different. If you disagree, please tell me why in the comments down below, and just say, I disagree because fuck you. Please just give me a reason. As always, remember to like, share, and subscribe. This is Nerd News, signing off.